What's up, y'all? It's the Modern Night. It's time for another one. So today we're going to talk about this Vanity Fair exclusive article for the Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker that's coming out the end of this year. And I want to give a big shout to my brother, Drunk3PO, because he brought this to my attention. And it was like, because initially I saw this video, I mean the article, and I was like, who cares? And I wasn't... Like, yeah, whatever. It's Star Wars pictures, Vanity Fair, whoop-de-whoop, blah, 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 right? So, I was like, whatever. But what caught my attention was that he brought up the point that allegedly that they're supposed to be getting rid of the, you know, the Jedi and the Sith of this. So this is where, whoa. I said, whoa. So you're going to tell me, you're going to tell me we're going to get rid of the Jedi and the Sith in this here movie? Really? Okay. So, excuse me. I pulled up a couple of, and I will put this in the description so you can check it out. Because it's an extremely long article, and I just skimmed through it real fast. I really wasn't trying to, because like I said, I'm not really interested in this right now. Right now, this is more of the, you know, wanting to see how much it burns down. That's what I want to see right now. How much can we burn this down? So here's a couple things I took out of this here, and we'll discuss it also. So it says, but the stakes go even higher than that, cosmically higher. Sources close to the movie say that Skywalker will at long last bring to a climax the millennia-long conflict between the Jedi Order and its dark shadow, the Sith. So, I want to stop right there with that, because when do we have the Sith in this? The sequel trilogy. Because if you're going by anything, the Sith was destroyed. It was destroyed already. Remember that. When Anakin destroyed Sidious, and Darth Vader, when he threw him over and became Anakin once more, the Sith were no more. Now, had you done something intelligent, like use, I don't know, the Lost Tribe of the Sith, like I've been saying so many times, instead of this bootleg Empire, First Order, you could say, okay, yeah, we could be ending the Sith, which, again, is stupid. It's really dumb. And here's another thing. The Jedi and Sith have been fighting for a lot longer than 1,000 years. 1,000 years has been the length of the Republic, the older Republic. Not the turmoil between the Jedi and the Sith. That went on for way longer than that. If you want to be technical, it went on about 50,000 years, you know, when it was just the Ashley and Bogan, and you had, you know, just Jedi versus Dark Jedi. But it's neither here nor there, because you guys don't know about Star Wars. You don't care. It's all about the dollars. It's all about the dollars, baby. That's all you want. So, if you were planning on getting rid of the Jedi and the Sith, please believe, I'm telling you right now, you might as well close up shop, wrap it up, and just let the product die down, and then sell it off to somebody who actually cares. Because, yeah, I guarantee you, if this is the truth, and you're going to do that, I will no longer support anything Disney. I don't like Disney to begin with. I've said this 1,000 times. I don't like Disney. I don't like their business operation. I don't like the fact that they have a monopoly at this point. I don't like the fact that they destroy everything that they get their hands on. I don't like Disney. So, please believe when I tell you this. You'll be bootlegged to high heaven if I am going to see anything from Disney. Just saying, it's just going to happen. That's just going to happen. I'm not going to be down with you. That's all I'm saying with that. But, let's get into this a little bit more also, because they have something very interesting they also bring in. And like I said, I only took a couple things out of this article because it's just ridiculously long. Kylo Ren has it all wrong. You can't bring back the past, and you can't become your own grandfather, and you can't kill the past either. All you can do is make your peace with what has been learned from it and move on. Abrams is doing that with the Star Wars. And meanwhile, the Resistance is going to have to do that too. If they're really going to bring this saga to an end, because we have been there before watching the band of scrappy rebels take on a techno-fascist empire, and it seemed to work fine at the time, but it didn't last. The same goes for the Jedi and the struggle with the Sith. To end this story, really end it, they're going to have to figure out the conditions of a more permanent victory over the forces of darkness. Their past is imperfect at best, and their present is a complete disaster, but the future is all before them. This time, finally, they're going to do it right. Now, the reason I put that in it because it's also combined on the fact that they're trying to get rid of the Sith. Again, if you're planning to get rid of the Jedi and the Sith, you might as well wrap it up. I'm just reiterating that. Wrap it up. It's over, B. It's like the Dave Chappelle skit. You had to sign them. Wrap it up, B. Wrap it up. It's over for you. But here's one thing you want to take a look at what this person said in the end. It says, the past is imperfect at best, and the present is a complete disaster. That just sounds like the whole Disney era of Star Wars right now. The present is a complete disaster, but the future is all before them. I see what they did there. You see that wording right there? They're basically saying what we've been telling you. You guys make crap. And that's what you've been doing this entire time. So, you know, when I hear that you're trying to get rid of the Sith, you're trying to get rid of the Jedi, and then I heard the whole thing about the theories that, you know, the Jedi will no longer be called Jedi, they'd be called Skywalker, something like that. I don't know. I'm just telling you right now, your writing sucks. It's the same thing I said to Rian Johnson when he's, you know, being his troll self, and I says, your Snoke writing sucks. I'm going to tell you right now, Disney, your whole Star Wars theory sucks. Everything on your Star Wars sucks. I mean, Rogue One was okay. The Force Awakens was all right, and that's it. It's all right. When you have an epic saga like Star Wars, it should be the all right. Now, look, you can say, well, D, the prequels. Yes, we know the prequels had this problem, but the thing the prequels has that this does not have is heart and soul of Star Wars. It just does. It does. I can watch the prequels again and not have a problem with it. As bad as they were, I can watch them. Of course, Revenge of the Sith is still my favorite of the prequels, and it's like my fourth overall Star Wars movie. But, you know where I stand with that. But my thing is, I can rewatch the prequels. There's no, my Force Awakens, I haven't touched it. It's no, what am I going to watch it for? It's the same thing with Game of Thrones. If I wanted to watch Game of Thrones again, why would I do it? Because I know how it ends. It ends like crap. Same thing with this. You know, from The Force Awakens to The Last Jedi, that's like a brick wall. It's like, oh, we're doing great. Pow! Done! Splat! And now we're going to say, oh, let's clean this up! Clean it up! Emergency! Call right with hazmat here! Hazmat! Let's get this cleaned up! Let's do a better one! That's what it's like right now. That's what I feel about the Star Wars that's coming up. I don't feel any kind of hype for it. I don't feel, you know, honestly, I don't even feel anything for it. I'm completely indifferent about Star Wars. And I shouldn't be. Star Wars is one of my favorite things that I grew up with. And I'm indifferent about it right now. Whose fault is that? Whose fault is that? Because I'm not the one who's putting this crap out. And now you can say, oh, well, you don't like it. You don't have. Don't tell me that. I don't want to hear that. Okay? Anybody who comes at me with that nonsense, I ignore you. Because you're telling me nonsense right now. Because I'm not going to say something that I grew up with that I'm just going to ignore. Because you can say the same people or whatever. Pick anything in your life that you grew up with, that you have a strong connection with, and then tell yourself, I'm not going to deal with that anymore. It doesn't have to be Star Wars. It could be sports. It could be knitting. It could be cars. It could be anything. So guess what? Your hobby that you like, just give up on it. It's not for you anymore. How does that sound? How does that sound to you? It sounds dumb, doesn't it? And that's how I feel when anybody tells me, oh, you should just get over it. It's a movie. Don't tell me that. But anyway, how do you guys feel about this information that the Sith and Jedi might be going away in The Rise of Skywalker? And do you think that the little theory about it being no longer called Jedi, but be called Skywalkers? But I think that actually is something from the EU, if I'm correct. I heard somebody say that in passing. So it's not even something new that they call, you know, Force users Skywalkers. I don't know. I'm not sure. I could be wrong with that because some of the EU, I didn't read the whole EU because it's got 40 years worth of EU. I mean, 30 years, basically. I didn't read all of it. I read maybe about 45% of it, but a lot of stuff I just, you know, between talking to people and learning, I learned about the EU. So I'm pretty sure I heard something about the that thing of the Force users being called Skywalkers. Not sure, don't hold me to that. But how do you feel about that? Do you think that this will be the end of Star Wars? It will be ending with thunderous applause, because guess what? Everybody applauded in that Rise of Skywalker when we was in Chicago. Everybody was happy about that. So it's going to end with a mouse and a thunderous applause. That's how Star Wars is going to die. Bottom line. Let me know how you feel about that. Like, share, and subscribe. But of course, hit that notification bell so you get my videos when I drop them. I'll catch y'all later. Peace. Oh. And, of course, I'm using Luke Skywalker for what? Stop. I can't quit. I'm heartless. You bullshit. Better off believe the president. My empire will seek peace and justice and fishing level. My planet is spotless on top of the game.